Hey everybody, welcome to Adventures in Furniture Flipping, presented to you by The Crafty Creech. My name is Crystal, and if you like flipping furniture and crafting and creating and just having fun, you definitely should subscribe to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I make these bedside tables look like faux-aged metal. I was so excited to find these freebies posted on Marketplace. My husband and I hopped up in the car and we drove right over and snatched them up. They were really close. We were the first ones there. That hardly ever happens to me. I made sure I checked all of the drawers and made sure they all opened and closed properly and nothing was broken. These are just a pair of laminate bedside tables, and the top is formica. There was a little bit of water damage on the particle board underneath of the laminate, so I had to repair that, and I'm going to show you how I do that in a second. But the first thing I did was I sanded them all down. I gave them a nice scuff sanding so that way my paint would adhere better. Then I cleaned them really good and made sure I got all the dust off and all the little debris and particles and also the spider webs. Where there was the damaged areas of particle board, I just took a screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver, and I chiseled away all the loose particle board, and then I took some sandpaper and I lightly sanded it down to make sure there was no debris there. Where the damage was, I used some spackling for drywall and I filled in the areas I chiseled out with my screwdriver, and one of the corners was pretty damaged and I need to add a lot of spackle to that area, and I formed a corner. I waited for the spackle to dry overnight before I started painting over that area. And of course, before I painted it, I made sure I sanded it to make sure it was smooth. I only did one coat of primer, and you guys are probably looking at this thinking I'm crazy because it looks so bad, but I promise you, I purposely did this. I am trying to create brush strokes so that way when I dry brush over my primer, my paint will pick up the ridges. I did not need this primer for bleed through. I only needed it for adhesion purposes. So here's my black paint, and this has been sitting in here a long time and it's kind of dry and thick, which is totally fine. There's nothing wrong with that. That actually, the thicker paint will actually give more texture. So I'm just going over this like so. I'm going to be using tons and tons of different colors of paint, different layers. I might use some purple. I might use some aqua blue. My plan is to make this look like old faux metal. I know this might look scary, but it's definitely going to be beautiful. It's just going to take a few steps to get it there. Adding some more black. So dry brushing is just a tiny bit of paint on your paintbrush. But you can see how my black paint is picking up all my brush strokes from my primer. And I'm really just sick and tired of flipping furniture and doing what sells and painting everything white and painting everything gray. I'm really just trying more unique ways of refinishing my pieces of furniture. I'm creating art. Now I am adding some purple. I'm going in all different directions. Probably think I'm corona bat crazy because these just look nuts and I should be locked up in an asylum or something, but I promise you they get better. Keep watching. Container with some water, and I'm going to do another coat of black, but this time I am going to water it down. By dipping my brush into my water. again, I am just going in both directions. A little bit more water. Right now, I am trying to cover up the white primer. As best as I can. Keep dipping your brush in the water and that will help thin down whatever is on your brush. So now that things are starting to dry, I'm going to take this 3M sanding sponge and I am going to sand over parts of this dresser and just to subtly expose some of those colors that we painted underneath of this black.
I'm going in both directions because I want it to look textured. By dipping my paintbrush into water, it thins down my black paint. That way, when I apply it to the dressers, it's sort of transparent, and the other colors that I put on previously just kind of subtly show through the black paint and darken a tad bit.
So per the usual, I've lost some of my footage. It happens to me every time. I don't know why, but I'm taking some of this copper colored paint and this green colored paint. I'm just lightly taking a little bit, putting it on my finger and just rubbing it here and there randomly where I think tarnished metal might be. I'm just doing this all over both dressers. I'm not really being mindful of how thick or thin it is because I'm going to go over it with my green paint as well as my black paint in a little while to tone anything down that might be too thick or too dark. Once I have my copper color paint on, I take my green colored paint and I am just lightly dry brushing over top of the copper paint. Think of like an old tarnish can or something like that. You can even probably go on the internet and find a picture of what a tarnished copper can looks like, and you can use that as your inspiration and kind of take some artistic ideas from it. This is the tedious part, and it takes a lot of extra time to make everything look the way you want it to look and perfect it. You can also take your black paint and dry brush it or thin it down with water and apply it over top the copper. Now I'm taking some brown antiquing wax and dipping a sponge in it with a little bit of water, then wiping it over top of the dresser to give a darkened effect and make it look a little bit more aged or dirty. I'm thinking worn and old and just something that has had a lot of wear and age. So I'm just putting it all over the place, maybe closer to where the handles are, so that way it gives a more natural feel or natural effect, because that might be where someone has touched more often and it might be a little bit more dirtier in those areas. This is where all the fun begins, and you can just be artistic and be creative and really just make your piece look and feel the way you want it to look by adding different waxes and different paints and really just having fun with it. I took some paper towel and just dabbed some areas off and wiped it and spread it out a little bit more where I thought it needed it. My next step is taking my brown antiquing wax and a artist brush, and I'm going over any areas where I see some white primer showing through, and I'm just dabbing around it. The dark wax almost makes everything look rusted, and I really love the way that looks, especially because most of the areas where my white primer is showing through is where my little metal brackets naturally sit. It's giving those an aged look, as well as the corners of my dresser drawers. I laid the dressers down on their back. That way I could see the white areas better, and I could also get in the corners easier with my paintbrush. I love how there are just so many uses for this brown wax. There's so many different things that you can do with it and so many different effects that you can create. I also took out the dresser drawers and I painted about an inch back on the inside. So that way, because the drawers do not sit flush with the front of the dresser, I made sure I hid any of the brown wood that was showing through from the inside of the dresser. I also painted the drawer front, sides, top, and bottom, so that way when the drawer was opened up, everything would match as well. I took a lot of extra time and just kind of dry brushed little areas here and there that I thought needed to blend a little bit better. That's really the tedious part about the whole thing. I cleaned up my drawer pulls. These were the original drawer pulls. I felt like they went really well with my industrial look of the piece, so I didn't want to change anything about those. The very last thing I did was I used a clear wax to seal. I applied the wax with a rag from a cut-up t-shirt, and then I was all done. I think it turned out great. I think this set of bedside tables are just a unique piece of art, and I really hope the new owners enjoy them and love them as much as I do. If you guys are interested in seeing any of my previous work, you can go check me out on Facebook at The Crafty Creech, Crafty with a K, or follow me on Instagram.
So let's get down to the nitty gritty and talk profit. My total investment on these bedside tables was $0. They were free. I had all my materials on hand. My time spent was approximately 8 hours. I spent the most time on my final coat of black, perfecting everything and making sure it was the way I liked it, which was took me about 3 hours, I would say. I listed these for $285. They sold within a few hours. I was swarmed with messages. Plus, I charged $50 delivery fee on top. I would say that's pretty good return on investment for a set of freebies. All right, you guys, let me know down in the comments what you thought about this video. If you like these, if you don't like them even, I'd like to know what you think maybe I could have done differently. I love to hear all about it. I read all the comments and they really make my day, especially when I get those compliments. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope y'all have a great day. Thanks.